Gungadin by Rudyard Kipling. You may talk a gin or beer when you're courted safe out here, and you're sent to penny fights and aldershot it. But if it comes to slaughter, you'll do your work on water, and you'll lick the bloomin' boots of him who's got it. Now in India's sunny clime, where I used to spend my time, a servant of Her Majesty the Queen, of all them black-faced crew, the finest man I knew was our regimental bistie, Gungadin. He was Dean, you limpin' lump of brick dust, Gungadin. Hi, slippery hithero! Water, get it, panty-low, you squidgy-nosed old idle Gungadin. The uniform he wore wasn't nothing much before, and rather less than half of that behind. For a twisted piece of rag and a goatskin water bag was all the field equipment he could find. When the sweatin' troop train lay sidin' through the day where the heat would make your bloomin' eyebrows crawl, we shouted everybody till our throats were bricky dry. Then we warmed him, because he couldn't serve us all. It was Dean, you heathen, where the mischief have you been? You put some jewelry in it, or I'll marrow you this minute if you don't fill up my helmet, Gungadin. He would dock and carry one till the longest day was done, and he didn't seem to know the use of fear. If we charged or broke or cut, you could bet your bloomin' nut he'd be waiting 50 paces, right flank rear. With his music on his back, he would skip to our attack and watch us till the bugles made retire. And despite his filthy eyes, he was white, clear white inside, when he went to tend the wounded under fire. Then it was Dean, with bullets kicking dust spots on the green. When the cartridges ran out, you could hear the front file shout, "Hi, ammunition mules and Gungadin." I shan't forget the night when I dropped behind the fight with a bullet with where my belt plate should have been. I was choking mad with thirst, and the man who spied me first was our good old grinning grunt, Gungadin. He lifted up my head, and he plugged me where I bled, and he gave me half a pint of water green. It was crawling, and it stunk, but of all the drinks I've drunk, I'm gratefulest to one from Gungadin. It was Dean, is a beggar with a bullet through his spleen. He's chawing up the ground and he's kicking all around. For God's sake, get the water, Gungadin. He carried me away to where a dooley lay, and a bullet come and drilled the beggar clean. He put me safe inside just before he died. "I hope you like your drink," says Gungadin. So I'll meet him later on in the place where he is gone, where it's always double drill and no canteen. He'll be squatting on the coals, giving drinks to poor damned souls. And I'll get a swigging ale from Gungadin. Yes. Dean. You Lazarusian leather, Gungadin. Though I've belted you and flayed you by the living God that made you, you're a better man than I am, Gungadin. This is a beautiful poem. from Rudyard Kipling. Rudyard Kipling, most of his poems focus in India, or India, the Middle East, Sudan sometimes, in that area. That's where he kind of grew up, and that's where he kind of felt most at home. So that's what he wrote about. Now, there's a couple of notes here first. Panilo, that is, be quick about it. A Bisti is a water carrier. They were Indians that were attached to British regiments. And they brought you water in the fights, they brought you water in March. They were actually fairly well appreciated and respected by the British soldiers in general. They could not actually join the British army, but they were respected in their roles. So, but I'm not going to bother with any kind of analysis of scansion or meter. The rhyming pattern should be fairly obvious. So let us just look. He has, what is it, AAB, CCB, and then it follows that same pattern twice for each verse. So you're talking 12 lines there, and then you have a kind of refrain. That's AABBA on the rhyming pattern. It generally keeps the syllable count for each line. There are a few times, especially in the refrain, that it either adds or drops one or two, especially in the last verse. But that will be the extent of my analysis on this poem. I'll have another one for you tomorrow.